a least square line or the alternative forms of the regression equations. Now, least square line means what? That the always the least square line passes through the mean. The passes through means what? It passes through the coordinates x mean comma y mean. Okay. So, let us write it. Now, first case is for x to be the independent variable. Now, equation of least square line, that is y is equal to mx plus c. Now, let us consider it as equation 1. Now, equation, or we can write it normal equation, okay. Instead of equation, let us write it normal equation now. Normal equation. Now, what I have written? Normal equation, okay. First of all, equation of least square line. Now, normal equation of least square line. Normal equation of least square line can also be written as is equal to nc plus x, m sorry, summation of x. Let this be equation 2. Okay. Now, dividing equation 2 by n. Now, dividing equation 2 by n means dividing both sides of equation 2 by n. So, what we are getting? Here we are getting now 1 upon n summation of y, 1 upon n dot nc plus m dot summation of x upon n. Sorry. Now, what this becomes? This becomes y mean is equal to c plus m x mean. Equation 3. Now, what we have used here? We have used y mean is summation for y upon n and x mean is summation for x upon n. Okay. And as I told you earlier also, I am requesting you again and again that we have to write like this, but just for a spacious part. Okay. I am just going for this part, okay, for the easiest part, okay. Don't think that I am just, I don't know how to write or I am just doing the careless mistake, okay. So, we can write like this also. Now, subtracting three from one, subtracting three from one means this equation is being subtracted from this one. So, what we are getting? We are getting y minus y mean is equal to m x minus x mean. Okay. Now, to this what we can write it? Or y minus y mean is equal to b y x x minus x mean. Okay. So, this is what? Now, here coordinates we are having y mean and x mean. Now, this shows what? No. This shows that, now this shows that the line passes through the mean, passes through mean. Mean means what? Coordinates are at x mean, y mean. Okay. So, this was what about the least square line. Now, we have also written alternative forms of the regression equation. Now, what are the alternative forms? If in place of BYX, we are putting the formulas, that is the alternative form. Okay. So, now, alternative form. Now, alternative form, first of all, let's write it regression equation. Regression equation of y on x. Now, how we are writing? Same equation what we have written here. So, this will be y minus y mean is equal to byx x minus x mean. Now, where what is b for y on x? Now, the formula which we have already derived. What the formula is, if you remember, it was xy minus n times x mean y mean upon x square minus n times x mean square. When we are going for y mean and x mean, then we can use this formula. Or if you remember using the Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation, this is equal to what? Sigma y upon sigma x. Okay, this is equal to sigma y upon sigma x. Or further, what we can write to this also? We can just write it that this can be written as, now I am just converting this in the summation form. Okay, so what we are having, we can write it this as n times sigma x y sigma y upon n times minus, like this, one and the same thing. We have already derived this part. Okay, now this was number one. Now number two, regression equations of x on y. Of x on y. Now, what we can write it? Same thing. Now, we can move this for as x minus x mean is equal to b x on y. It means y minus y mean. Where b x y. Where b x y. Okay, I am writing it. Where b x y. Here now it becomes what? Sorry. Summation for x y minus n times x mean y mean upon summation for y square minus n times y mean square. Now, this becomes again by sigma x upon sigma y. And this, if further we have to convert it, what we can write it? We can write it n times x y x summation of y upon n whole square. So, these are the alternative forms.